Latino men gunned down in Butler County.
Investigators say that a dangerous gang that set up shop right here in the tri-state is still here, actually, is behind the killings. News 6's Karen Johnson is covering the trial for us tonight of an alleged MS-13 gang member and joins us live. Karen?
Well, Sherry, he wasn't the trigger man, but prosecutors say he worked with another MS-13 gang member to kill two Latino men in Fairfield. That was the summer of 2008, and his trial started this week. And witnesses said today that the victims may have been targeted because they wore red.
MS-13 gang signs thrown in court today. During testimony, Jimmy Jose Enamorado Gomez says he first saw the defendant, Del Hernandez Martinez, and his boys flash that gang sign at a Cincinnati bar, and then again at the Tri-County Mall in the summer of 2008. The reason, he says, through an interpreter,
they demand respect.
A few months later, Jimmy's brother and friend were gunned down while sitting in a car outside Casa Tequila in Fairfield. Prosecutors say Martinez was behind the killing. Jimmy watched his brother die.
I saw him and I got to see him. It was horrible. I never seen him like that. And I can swear they never had problems with anybody. They were two good people. All this just because my brother wore red.
18th Street gang members wear red. Jimmy says his crew isn't part of the rival gang, but may have been mistaken for members. After this double homicide, I investigated gangs filtering into the suburbs. Testimony today from an FBI agent who asked not to have her face shown confirmed what I reported nearly 3 years ago. MS-13 members are here in the tri-state.
Some MS-13 members were residing in Westchester, Ohio, Carthage, up in Columbus, many in Dayton.
And a popular gang hangout, Brewskis or Parazos, the Fairfield club where both groups of men had argued the night of the murders.
And another man, Hector Ratana, also an alleged MS-13 gang member, has also been charged with these murders, although no trial date has been set yet. He's currently in jail in North Carolina on unrelated murder charges and faces murder charges in Hamilton County. Reporting live tonight in Hamilton, Karen Johnson, News.